But now we are within the ancient city walls and we are exploring what was the foyer of the theater of Pompeii, the foyer, a waiting room. The Pompeians came here for chatting, for gossiping, for wasting time as we do today in the modern foyer. The plans that you see are original. The flight of steps that you see there, there, and there are original. So it means that there were two floors and a portico all around. This area was used as a barrack, gymnasium for the gladiators. That's why the little rooms that you see all along were excavated. So those are the rooms, the cellars, where the slaves, where the gladiators fly. And on the glass there, they trained for fighting into the amphitheater, which is quite far from here, 30 minutes walking, far from here.
Where 1,000 spectators could see the floor is an original floor made of colorful, multicolored marbles. That was the stage, the ancient balconies, where the musicians used to play their instruments. The stands that you see there are original, and the cavea was divided into three different levels. It were quite dirty, bad smelling, so to not get wet feet, they use the stepping stones for walking from a sidewalk to the other.
Yeah. These are the places left by the wheels of wagons passing in between.
Yes.
So the wagons were at a standard size, so wide, very long, with big wheels covered by iron.
Wine barn of 2,000 years ago, a
To the foreigners coming to Pompeii looking for a job as well. Looking for, for make money, because Pompeii offered this kind of opportunity to, people.
So it's trading.
Yes, trading.
These little side bits aren't particularly wide for a lot of people to walk.
By the foot of the Mount Vesuvius, they had an incredible vineyard destroyed. Right? Anyway, that's the vestibule with the entrance. And we are standing in the atrium. This is the atrium by the ancient city walls of the town of Troy. There were beds, clean eye in here. There was a sofa there, bed there, another there, and another there. The sofa standing at the bottom was reserved to the most important guests, and it was used to let them enjoy the view of the atrium during their banquets. During their banquets, they stooned and they walked to the other room that you see there, which was called the vomiting room. So they vomited everything they ate in that room before we starting to eat again here. This in winter. Surrounded by other columns, other pillars, which are original. The ceiling that you see here, even if the beams are reconstructed, are original.
It's quite big.
Okay, so the rooms that you see, now I'll explain it to you, the rooms that you see there, were rooms belonging to another private residence. So there was a floor here, and that is the ancient floor belonging to other rooms belonging to another more ancient private residence covered by these. The frescoes are original. Here you see some skeletons of 2,000 years ago. They died, probably for the collapse of a wall.
Yes.
They couldn't find the treasure. We found it. stored into the Archaeological Museum of Naples. 118 pieces. This is an original mosaic. The myth of Diana and Atene here. Diana and he saw Diana enjoying the bath, swimming in this beautiful lake.
Is it just one house?
It's just
one house. Just the one
house?
Yes.
And the family was made of women and men, but we are going to see the public baths, which were divided into sections, two sections. They are represented. So columns in the foreground, in the background, the pillars, archways with a wood in the background, so trees, maritime pine trees. All right.
This is the
word
flash coming around. You can't really tell where everything is supposed to be.
So it's
Yeah, but it is much smaller.
Stop the lava with the barricades, no. And it depends also by the wind. I mean, it's just a big risk. It's just a big risk. And they want to stay there and stay there. I mean.
So nothing changes in Pompeii then?
With the terracotta bricks in the foreground, a kind of a volcanic room in the background for housing the Benowood pizza was. But they produced bread. As a matter of fact, there are 36 bakeries of Pistrinia, like that one in Pompeii. So production of bread was something very important for the local economy. They used the spa. The public baths were made of two sections. There was the male section and the female section. And this was the common room, the gymnasium. So they used to spend their daily workout in here. And there's four rooms. There was the apoditerium, dressing and waiting room. The frigidarium, cold water room. The tepidarium, the steam room. And the calidarium, so the hot air passed through the double floor and double walls, heating the two rooms. And the water into the jacuzzi included, into the pool. Like that one, you see? But it was an open air pool, not very deep, just stay relaxed. It's original as well, embellished by beautiful medallions. Representing mythological subjects. This was the frigidarium, a cold water room with a water tap just in the front, so there was a current here in the house. This was the calidarium, hot water room, and that was the tepidarium, the steam room. So you see the double floor, and there was another room, another room, small room, where there was a fireplace at high temperature. So the hot air was pushed to pass through the gap, the intersection between the bottom and the floor, and the same for the walls. And the liquid plaster, not solid, filled up the cavities. So this we then got plaster casts of human bodies, plaster casts of the Pompeians, so that's so forget it. In the embellished inside by five rooms, and on the walls you can see frescoes representing the different positions of love. These are some of the best preserved frescoes of Pompeii. The Pompeians, they just appointed the position that they would like to get, and they got it.
Fortunately, or unfortunately, as the case may be.
In Pompeii, I promised you to have pointed at that, and that's the bell tower of the sanctuary of the Pontifical Basilica that you see standing next to the bell tower. So that is the modern...
Which the first available...
Weird.
And that's correct, because we are coming from that corner.
We saw that at Ephesus in Turkey, they had a sort of sign similar. Not like that.
So the Forum of Pompeii was the center of the economical, political, social life.
Perfect for killing the germs, for disinfecting everything. They didn't smell like urine because they added perfumes at the end of the washing process. It was a big business about the urine in Pompeii, because the urine was collected into the private toilet and public toilets to be carried there, to be cured in amphoras, and to be sold. So according to the previous song, you should know that in Pompeii, pecunia non olet, money doesn't stink. So even with urine, I can make money putting a tax on the urine of the Pompeians.
Crazy.
So now I would like to point out to you some other plaster casts of human bodies.
Like the one here of the pregnant lady. You see, this is the plaster cast of... Another plaster cast, probably of a slave. Taller than the Pompeians. The Pompeians, as I told you before, were short and buff. Wheat into the different holes, so they knew the right weight of the wheat. It was a gift given by a politician, it's Flaccus, Claudius Flaccus.
This was the area where the Temple of Venus stood.
Venus.
So we have started our tour talking about Venus, because I told you that the name of Pompeia's Roman colony was Cornelia.
It gives you the scale, doesn't it, of where it came.
No,
That puts it into the